I'm Dr. Taryl Kirk. I'm currently an assistant professor at Rowan University. My background is in condensed matter physics, which is essentially the study of matter, in particular some metals and semiconductors and, say, insulators, so at the condensed state. And I study, like, the electronic and magnetic properties of these materials. In particular, most recently, I developed a high-resolution scanning electron microscope to evaluate the surface and look at various characteristics of these materials. I've been teaching mainly introductory courses because I feel that this is the best way to engage students and draw them into physics. So in particular, I've been teaching introductory mechanics and introductory electricity and magnetism, which of course is directly correlated with a lot of my research. So I like to show various elements of this to my classroom. For me, a FIP classroom is essentially taking the lower cognitive methods, for instance, understanding, and taking that out of the classroom and have this done at home. In particular, I want the students to focus on more higher cognitive ideas such as deep understanding and critical thinking within the classroom. So that's the main concept for me behind flipping the classroom. In terms of Blackboard, I essentially use that mainly to give links for the students for the podcast in terms of the flipped classroom where they have the traditional lecture at home or however they like to view the podcast. So I have podcast lectures that are on the Helix Library server as well as iTunes. And I have perhaps about two of these podcasts that the students have to watch per week. So that's the video lecture assignment that they have. And in addition to that, with Blackboard, I use a method known as just-in-time teaching. And just-in-time teaching allows me to understand what the students need in exactly the moment that they need it. So after the students watch the podcast or during watching the podcast, they will be posting on the discussion board some of the problems that they've had. And this is done directly on Blackboard. And that's what I use to gear my lectures or what I do in class for the students. And in addition to that, I also have some simulations that students do, such as FET simulations and also other ones that come through Pearson and other tools from physics education research. Well, I have two forms of quizzes that I have. One is an online quiz that accompanies the podcast lecture. So during the podcast lecture, they would, for instance, read or view one specific section of that podcast. And after that specific section, they're going to have a quiz to see if they really understand the material. If they feel that they're not comfortable in taking a quiz yet, they could actually return to the beginning of that section and redo the section and then take the quiz. So all of these quizzes have to be done prior to coming to the class where it's going to be discussed. And in the classroom itself, I also give some sporadic quizzes as well. In the two introductory courses that I was currently teaching, in particular introductory mechanics and introductory electricity and magnetism, the class is completely flipped, so it's 100% flipped classroom. To be very honest with you, this essentially came from one of my methods that I use for assessment. In particular, I give all of the students an oral evaluation. And what I noticed, because I track how the students are performing the whole entire course, some of the students that have high grades, for instance A's or B's, have very difficulty explaining some of the concepts that are behind what I'm doing. And another assessment I do is a pre and a post assessment. So I see what the students have learned throughout the course. And I've noticed through this that the students were scoring relatively low. They haven't been learning a lot through the concept inventory. And this is one of the main driving forces behind it. Another one I would have to mention is that I needed more time to work directly with the students. And this allows me to do that. As I've already hinted towards a bit, it's more student-centered. And that was my key driving force, was to make it more student-centered. And another thing that it really allowed me to do is that not only do I spend more time understanding what the students' needs are, I see more of, through this discourse, a deeper understanding of systematic problems that students have that are, of course, reported in physics education research, but it does somewhat differ from class to class. So this is what it allows me to do. Yes, of course. This is definitely what I'd say is one of the main goals of flipping the classroom, is that you have more practical training of the students inside the classroom. And I think this is very positive, especially for a student-centered university such as Rowan. Yes, I definitely would agree with that. Now is the technology age, and the students are very comfortable using their phones and going online, and they do a lot of work online, you know, just and on their leisure as well. So if you could incorporate this as an educational tool, then I think the students would really benefit from this. Well, for me, I believe that it has worked very well, but I can't say that this is going to be the case for everybody. It depends on how comfortable you are with it. For me, to interact with the students, I feel very comfortable doing that, and I think the students benefit from my style of teaching in that regard, but it may not be for everyone. Oh yes, since most students have never had a flipped classroom course before, a lot of it is still adjusting to it. In particular, because flipped classroom really needs a lot of interaction with the students, in particular for the just-in-time teaching, many students are having difficulty adjusting to that, where they're going to have to prepare themselves before a lecture and make known parts that they have difficulties with. And even in the classroom, I've noticed this has been a problem. And one of the things that we thought about doing in order to counteract this is to have a learning assistant involved. Some students are uncomfortable expressing their difficulties directly to a professor, but they're much more comfortable explaining this to a learning assistant, which would be a student who had already taken the class and done really well, for instance, a physics major, and they would be working directly with the students. Well, of course, the most positive thing that I've seen is via this assessment, which is what led me to flip the classroom in the first place. So the average gain that the students have had looking at their, comparing the pre-assessment to the post-assessment for my classes, which is done in a traditional method, was about 25%. This is quite low, considering that the students are starting off quite low as well. And after flipping the classroom, I was surprised myself, because the increase in that average gain went from about 25% to about 40 to 60%. So it was a significant gain. Well, it was, how should I say, a bit overwhelming. Because to get the flipped classroom going, in particular to prepare the podcast, was very time consuming. And also with the interactions with the students, many of the students like to do their work late at night. So to respond to them in time was very difficult. So that was one thing that made it very difficult. And in terms of any negative problems I've noticed is more in particular with the way students view how physics should be taught. So many of them see it more as a mathematics type course, where they expect the instructor to show some problems to demonstrate what they should know, and then they basically try to see how these problems are done and try to do the same thing, to mimic, essentially, my problem-solving ability. But in terms of what my goal was strictly for mastery of the material, and it was more driven towards understanding the concepts, because with a deeper understanding of the concepts, the students could apply this to more and more techniques. And to get that transition was some of the difficulties I experienced. So some of the other methods that I've used with the flipped classroom and introducing new technology is one that I've already mentioned before. I have the students use various simulations in class, and this is done on a computer. And for instance, we do like mini labs using these type of simulations. And in addition to that, the students also prepare some videos sometimes of demonstrations that they've done or something that they saw outside dealing with physics, and they post that on the discussion board. I think any professor that is or desires to be very engaged with the students, to have a more student-centered lecture versus a professor-centered lecture, would really benefit from this. Well, first and foremost, if you would like to flip your classroom, the most important thing is that you have to clear a lot of time, because to put all your podcasts together, however you desire to do it, would be very time consuming. But the most important thing is to, before you even flip the classroom, increase the interaction between you and your students to see how you could better fulfill their needs in terms of learning. That's, I think, the most important thing. And that's what I was trying to do as I was flipping the classroom.
Okay. Thank you for your time.
You're welcome.